While you wait for me, look at the center box where you have your topic. Remember, I always leave off part of the title of the topic because you're trying to figure out the lesson through your problem. Good job, Jaden. Through the problem. So look at the look at that middle box. Make sure your PBL is in front of you. So problem-based learning is basically switching the teaching around. So you are no longer doing direct instruction where you're just teaching everything as a teacher. So for problem-based learning, I developed a graphic organizer that looks a lot like the gate template. It has this the box in the center where I pose the topic, but then I only do part of the title because oftentimes in the curriculum, the title already is telling them what the lesson's gonna be. In problem-based learning, you want them to get there on their own. Okay, topic 4-4, blank, read the rest with me. Two-digit numbers. We're gonna do something with two-digit numbers. Okay, let's go to the problem box on your PBL sheet. Add. 26. Explain how you solved the problem. And last part, show your very good. What do we use to better understand your problem? Raise your hand. Dominic, what should we use? Use cubes. So go in your orange folder. Find your cube sheet. Mine's up here. Cubes is like close reading. We use cubes. It's a strategy to help us understand better. Good. To have a better understanding. So let's look at our problem. Then we start with the first box, which is the problem box. And that's where I have the problem typed. And I have that there so when we use the cube strategy, they are able to write on the problem. They're doing all the steps. They're circling, boxing. You're able to see their annotations. So after we break up the problem with cubes, we move to the independent box where now the students have an idea of what operation or how they're gonna solve the problem. Think about your strategy, write what you're gonna use. So you're not solving yet, you're just writing your strategy on top. The first step is just you getting your minds going because the real work is gonna be when you talk to your partner, right? So I'm gonna let you work for 2 minutes by yourself. Independent is voice level?
Zero.
2 minutes to solve this problem. Go.
In this step as the teacher, I'm not expecting them to get it right. I mean, I would hope that they would, but for me, my expectancy is for them to get their mind going, to be able to choose a strategy, and to be able to explain why they chose that.
So you're gonna keep looking and you're independent because now when you talk to your partner and you have that discussion piece using your math talk sentence frames, you're explaining your work. You're doing the show your work part. You should have showed it. So now not only are you gonna tell your partner what you used, what strategy, but explain it.
In the partner box, they first discuss with their partner using their math talk sentence frames what they did.
I use cubes because it's an easy strategy to use by putting 10s and 1s together.
Make sure you responded.
Eventually we'll lead into where they're discussing and solving on their own. So I set the timer, let them talk for about a minute and decide within each other if what strategy they want to use, if they want to keep theirs, but they have to pick one together.
46.
And then go down one time.
Wait.
Wait,
you're supposed to have
So, well, okay. So we're gonna add parsley.
During that time, during the partner time, I'm walking around and I'm picking those students who are going to help lead the class to that lesson. So they're going to be the models. They're going to be the teachers. So Mercedes and Aiden, you want to show us your strategy? Last one. And this is going to lead to our lesson. We're going to do more of this today. And it goes with the place value blocks. Ready? Okay, let's give them our attention. So now they think it's time for them to show off their answers. Whereas, again, you as the teacher know where the lesson's going. So now you have chosen 2 to 3 groups who come up and explain, and the whole class is listening. So this should look familiar. She just did a chart. She just said you're splitting it into what, Mercedes? Tens and?
One.
What does this look like? Our math problem we used today, right? So you split up your ones and your tens. Now I'm gonna be quiet, it's hard for me. So Mercedes and Aiden, you gotta jump in, go.
This is the equal 12, but you can't put on the ones because the one is a 10.
And then once you get the students up there and they lead the direction you want, that's the strategy you choose to do as a whole class. You're taking over as the teacher, but they still don't know that. The students are thinking that they're still leading it. Turn to your paper to the whole class, and we're gonna use 2 strategies. We're gonna use the place value blocks to model, and then we're gonna add using place value with regrouping. Let's draw each group first, ready? Let's do 46. How many tens in my 4 in 46?
4.
On the next side of this right here, draw a line down the middle. We're gonna write 46. And on the bottom of that, 26. And we're gonna follow Mercedes' example the way she did it's called a T chart, kind of making a T. You're doing a line down
in
the
math,
middle.
I think it's very important to have students think in a way where there's not just one way to do a problem anymore. And that's why PBL, problem-based learning, works very good with Common Core, because like just this lesson, I had the problem solved 3-4 different ways, and they got the same answer.